Welcome back to part two of the desert biome. There are some environmental issues that can affect the desert biome. Obviously, global warming, which some people think are an issue and some do not, but global warming is increasing the amount of deserts found on our land. It'll cause extreme droughts, which can convert a grassland to a desert, and so on and so forth. Off-road vehicles and some of the things we like to do for fun can mess up the vegetation and home life for many of the organisms that live in the desert. So think about it before you get a dune buggy and go out on the deserts of Nevada, Arizona, and Utah. Irrigation can cause many problems. I know you talk about irrigation in social studies, but irrigation with a biome can be totally different. Irrigation, when taught in social studies, is a good thing in which you can bring in water to a place that doesn't have a lot of water. But do know that energy and matter cannot be created nor destroyed. It can only be transferred or transported. So if you're moving water from one location to another, you're technically taking water from where it was and putting it somewhere else. So can that removal of water actually create more deserts? Remember, for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. It's always cause and effect. When we do one thing, we may cause an effect that may be catastrophic, or also called desertification. Grazing animals can often eat much of the vegetation that's found in the desert, leaving it a barren landscape. Nuclear waste and byproducts can also kill the vegetation around where that facility is located. That nuclear waste can create a desert. Please take a few minutes, hit the pause button, and see if you can figure out what type of symbiosis each one of these are. You have scenario 1, scenario 2, and scenario 3. Each one of these are found in a desert biome. I'll give you 3 minutes to try to figure it out. Okay, for scenario 1 in the Mojave Desert, you'll notice a wasp will lay its eggs on a praying mantis and then feed and kill the praying mantis. If you said this type of symbiosis was parasitism, you're correct. If you looked over here at bees, in which they pollinate the flowers of the cactus and help the cactus reproduce, this type of symbiosis would be mutualism, because the bees get a food source and the flowers get pollinated to make more offspring. Scenario 3. A cactus wren will make its nest in the tall chola cactus to protect its young from predators. The cactus is neither harmed nor helped. This type of symbiosis would be commensalism, because commensalism keywords are neither helped nor harmed, and there you can see the little wren. I'll give you about 5 minutes to write down this material on your Frayer model notes for desert. You're responsible for knowing each and every one of these facts that I've put here for you. Please study 15 minutes every single night. You can cut these cards out, rewrite them, and make note cards if you want to. But again, the location of the desert is located at the Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn, about 30 degrees north and south latitude, mainly found in North America, Africa, and Australia. The climate, extremely hot or extremely cold. The average rainfall is the lowest of any biome at less than 25 centimeters per year. Average temperature, 100 degrees Fahrenheit in the summer, 45 in the winter. Not many plants found here. Cactus, agave, which is used to make tequila, and tumbleweeds are found here. The fauna or animals I talked about and your textbook talks about are jackrabbits, spade-footed toads, kangaroo rats, lizards, buzzards, and camels. Some interesting facts is that this biome has the least amount of biodiversity. It also has the least amount of rainfall out of any biome. It has extreme temperatures, and most animals are active only at night, and they're said to be nocturnal. They must be adapted to live in these extreme conditions. I hope you found some of those adaptations very unique to the Aboriginal people who drank the urine from the frog to stay alive. Not to mention the frog can sleep for 7 years. Amazing. You have 5 minutes to get this material down.